where are we going to invest our resources? I want to propose one way to do that would be through the Christmas gift to the king. But before we get there, I want to have a few disclaimers. This is just one small application. There are many, many ways that we can serve the Lord. Many ways we can serve ourselves. Many ways we can serve the Lord. So this is one small application. This is also not a tithe. And so there's no biblical mandate to give the Christmas gift to the king. This is quite literally a gift. And if God might put on your heart the desire to sponsor something, then by all means, that would be a great gift for this church and for Christ. This is an investment into church infrastructure. There are a whole lot of things, and I'm going to talk about these, but there's a whole lot of things that could be used to make Sunday morning worship services better, to also make them more accessible and to make them reach younger generations a little better. Improving communication, there's all kinds of things that we can do to make this time flow a little more smoothly. All costs are estimates, and so there's been a lot of research done on each one of these things, but it's an estimate. It's not hard of a fact. And it's also not comprehensive. The Christmas gift to the king list is not comprehensive. There's many ways we can improve as a church. There's many things we can do to do a better job maybe reaching our community. One of those is our website. And that's such for our generation, it's pretty much the front door for the millennials. First, before they would hear about a church, they want to go and check it out. Before they visit the church, they want to go check it out online. How it looks is a direct representation of what we feel about our church. Is it well done? Is it thought out? Is it pretty? Do we invest resources into it? And if so, then that's going to help others have more of an attitude to maybe check it out. It's just a great way to reach people who might not otherwise come in the door. It'd be nice to have a printer. To have a good, trustworthy, I'm a huge fan of color laser printers. So if we wanted to print really good, high quality bulletins on the spot during the week, we could do that here. And also if we wanted to print on anything that we want to hand out in the community, we could do that here. I know Osceola is very fired up. The Hispanic Church is very fired up about going to departments. And if we had something like a printer with a lot of good ink, then we could print that stuff in-house and immediately go out and take it. And it'll look really sharp, look really good. And an estimate on that would be about in the range of 250. And as far as graphics for the website, maybe about 100. Member software. This is really important because we need a good software to keep track of donations from members. To facilitate communication. This software that we're looking at would allow children to check in, and so we have more young families that would come here. We'd be able to actually register their children and make sure that they're safe. Communicate via text, communicate via email, track attendance so that people hopefully don't fall through the cracks. And so these are all things that comes with that. That's $20 a month for that software. I've used it in previous churches and it's worked great for us. A video camera. I really appreciate Ron letting us borrow his video camera on Sunday mornings. But if we had a church dedicated video camera, we can shoot things, video, whether it be advertisements, whether it be just doing interviews of members, we can put that stuff on the website, on YouTube. As we already do broadcast services, we can continue doing that and maybe even increase the quality of the picture a little bit. Worship software, which this is one that gets me really fired up, but it's a hard sell, I think, because this is all run off PowerPoint right now, but what the worship software enables you to do is have scrolling announcements prior to the service, enables you to automatically download any kind of hymns, any kind of lyrics, and so that way, whenever we're just for the hymns, if we had the worship software, you would have the option, if you wanted to, of looking at the screen and following on the screen, if you wanted to. And so, scrolling announcements, having everything organized, all that it'll really help us make the service portrait more seamless. And then, speaking of screens, This is one that I'm particularly passionate about, which is worship monitors. And right now, I'm sorry to you guys over here. The ability to see scripture as we're speaking, to follow along on the screens, the ability to read hymn lyrics, the ability to do video presentations, to do graphics, to do things that will help facilitate the teaching and the worship on Sunday mornings. I think these are really important. And I had a guy from Best Buy here last week, and he was recommending that we put them on the outside of the stained glass, and so we wouldn't have to move anything around. And we could run wires that would hopefully be hidden, and I think it would look really good. And then we could use this, like with the children's ministry, and so they could watch videos, which would be great to help kind of keep them learning, but also in a not disruptive place. And then also security cameras. And we don't know the exact price for what the security cameras would be, but as we would upgrade our church, safety is just so important. Having children is so important to have cameras to make sure that there's no question that what's going on in there is honoring to God, there's accountability. If anything, God forbid, would be stolen from our church, churches get robbed all the time, we would at least have that as a deterrent and we'll probably be able to catch it or give valuable information to the police for anything to be stolen. And then there's other. And there's a lot of stuff I didn't think of. There's a lot of stuff I didn't say. Maybe God's put in your heart that we need a strobe light out front to welcome people in. We'll run that by the session and see if they approve. But if there's something on your heart that you feel particularly passionate about, you'd like to donate to the church. And again, there's many ways to give. We're going to have a garage sale, which is not going to be a real garage sale, because we don't have a garage. We're going to have a garage sale in a few months. And so if there's even things that you can set aside that you might want to sell for that, that's something that really help us out as well. And then there's so many other ways to give also. Just continuing to be here, continuing to invite friends. Little things like liking videos on Facebook or sharing those. That's a way to get the word out about our church. It's a way to help reach our generation, reach the world for Christ. Most importantly, to, of course, continue to grow in your own walk. That as we would speak, that people would hear Christ, as we would act, people would see his love. And so this is just a kind of a quick summary of the Christmas campaign. If you would be interested, you do see on your bulletin, on the back, you have some of the details. And then also you have the outline that's in the middle of it. If you would want to just, what I'd ask you to do is maybe just put this in the spot where you can pray about it. And pray about it. And if you feel strongly in favor of helping out in an area, that's awesome. If not, that's okay too. That's perfectly fine. I think these things would really help the church out a lot, but I trust that.